guys, so today's topic is makerspace learning. A little bit about makerspace learning, it's to inspire deeper learning from our students. This is a hands-on activity and we want to get our students engaged and initiated in thinking without a teacher scaffolding. So we want the student to be creative. We want them to show us what they know. So today, I'm going to show you an activity that uses one paper plate. Super cost efficient, super easy to do, only takes like 5 minutes, but I'm telling you, it's endless hours of activities for your students. So hang out with me here and I will show you a little bit about our cheap, technology-free, hands-on makerspace project. Thanks, guys. So like I said, all you need is one paper plate, two or three different colors, pieces of paper, different designs, kind of totally up to your students, and a set of markers. Now, the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to have your students use markers to design their paper plates. They can do anything they want, and this is the first step of creativity for your students. So the next step, after you have your students draw a design on it, and I know mine's very poor, but I did polka dots, your next step is going to be to have each student cut out however many, whatever size, slips of paper they want to have. These slips of paper are going to become the bridges. So I'm going to cut two more thick, long strands. So then I have these two thick ones and long, and a couple short ones. Okay. So our next step is going to be attaching the paper to the plate. The last step we have to do is we are just going to make a little ring for our marble, or in this case, all I have is an M&M as my marble. You will flip up the edges of your paper plate so that it makes a little ring that your marble or your M&M or whatever round object you'll be using cannot fall off. We're just going to flip this up like this, and you can see how my paper plate, maybe if you go to shape inside, is rounded at the top. At this point, our makerspace project is done. So to use, very simple. You will just have your students take a marble and they're going to try to maybe make a path. Say I'm going to follow these polka dots right here with my marble. And they're just going to try to get the marble through every hoop. Now that our makerspace project is done, I just want to give you a couple ideas for your students that I have come up with for them to get more engaged in this activity. So one thing that I found to be a very popular idea was to have multiple students make the exact same track. They put the exact same bridges up and they race. So as soon as someone says go, the marble is dropped into the rink. like this, and they decide, you know, you need to go over this one first, this one second, this one third, or however you want to do it. But I've realized that that seems to be a very popular thing to do. Thanks for being here with me, and I hope you find this makerspace cheap, cost-effective, easy, not so time-consuming, and technology-free. I hope you have a great one, and good luck!